See this. Now next we need to discuss problem number 6. Problem number 6 under liquidator's final statement of account. Again one more 12 mark problem we are going to see now. See this. The following was the balance sheet of Good Luck Limited as on 31st March 2016. So liabilities and asset information is given, balance sheet. Liability side, there is a share capital. If you see the share capital, 20,000 shares of 10 each, that is 2 lakh rupees. Bank overdraft is given and they have mentioned it is unsecured. That is nothing but bank overdraft is an unsecured creditor. That is 1,100 they have mentioned. Then partly secured creditor is there. Partly secured means some of the amount is unsecured and some of the amount is secured. So that is why they have mentioned you partly secured creditor, that is 29,180. Salary for 6 months is given 6,300. Then they have mentioned, yes, if you see here, then they have mentioned tax due to government. Tax due to government is 800 rupees. So this salary, 4 months is preferential, remaining 2 months is unsecured creditor. Taxes to the government, it is like preferential payment, it is to be paid first. Tax you cannot avoid, you need to be company need to pay the taxes to the government immediately if there is any tax. So it is preferential in nature, entire amount is preferential. Trade creditor, you need to see whether this is a preferential or unsecured. Usually it is unsecured trade creditor. Now asset side, there is a goodwill, intangible asset given. Then building machinery stock, debtor, cash. Building machinery fixed stock, debtor, cash, current and P&L debit balance, that is 1,38,080 is mentioned. So now below this they have given you some of the adjustment. If you see here, the company went into liquidation and the assets were realized as follow. So now here, building, first what they have said, building which was used in the first instance to pay partly secured creditor on the basis of pro rata, that is 18,000. So pro rata means what? Pro rata means some portion of the secured creditor is settled with the help of building. So now here if you see, what is a secured creditor information, that too partly secured creditor information we want here. See this, partly secured creditor 29,180 given in the balance sheet. Now they said that 18,000 with the help of building they have settled. So remaining amount is there, right? Remaining amount, that is unsecured. 29,180 minus 18,000, remaining is unsecured. Next, machinery 25,000, debtor 43,500, stock 31,000. That is nothing but realized amount they have mentioned. These amount, these items are there in the balance sheet asset side. Now they have given you realized amount after adjustment, after liquidation process. So now they have also given you the expenses of liquidation amounted to 1,100 rupees. So that you can write directly, the liquidator's remuneration was agreed at 3% on the amount realized except cash. So here they have specifically mentioned except cash you need to calculate liquidator's remuneration on the amount realized. Then 2% on the amount paid to unsecured creditor other than preferential creditor. So again they have given you other than preferential creditor. Sometimes they will mention on the amount realized to unsecured creditor. In that case, unsecured creditor also includes preferential creditor. But in this problem, they have specifically given other than preferential. So only on the unsecured creditor, we are going to calculate liquidator's remuneration, that is 2%. Prepare liquidator's final statement of account. So now we need to diversify, or we need to categorize here what is a secured, or what is a secured creditor and what is an unsecured creditor. Why? Because there is a salary given in the problem, there is tax information given in the problem, there is a partly paid, partly secured creditor is mentioned in the problem. So we don't know what portion is a secured creditor, what portion is unsecured creditor. That is why we need to do the format. We need to do this format. See this now, categorizing preferential creditor and unsecured creditor. So calculation of preferential and unsecured creditor. Yes, so particular preferential creditor, unsecured creditor, three column. First, bank overdraft. Bank overdraft preferential creditor is nil. Why? Because if you see the question, they have mentioned that is bank overdraft fully unsecured. In the bracket they have given unsecured. So entire amount you can write under unsecured creditor, 1100. Then partly secured creditor, if you see 29,180 given in the balance sheet. Now this 29,180 is settled with the help of building by the liquidator. That is 18,000 on the pro rata basis. That means still some of the amount is pending. So that pending amount is there, right? That is difference amount, 29,180 minus 18,000, difference amount, that is unsecured creditor. Preferential creditor is not there, that is nil. Why? Because we don't know. This is a partly secured creditor. That is why preferential is nil, unsecured is a difference amount, 11,180. Then salary. Salary for 6 month is given. See this salary for 6 month, that is 6,300. Now what you need to do here, that is 4 month salary is preferential, I have told you. That is why 6,300 into 4/6 we need to do. So you'll get 4 month salary. So 6,300 is 6 month salary together they have given you. So we need to want only 4 month salary. 4 month salary, 4/6. So that is 4,200. This 4,200 is less than 20,000. Again, there's a rule, up to 20,000 you can allow it as preferential payment. If it is more than 20,000, then it is unsecured. So it is less than 20,000, preferential payment, up to 4 month salary due, workman salary, that is allowed as preferential creditor. Next, there is unsecured creditor, how to get? So remaining amount, 6,300 minus 4,200. So out of 6,300, 4,200 is a preferential creditor, means remaining balancing figure, that is unsecured creditor. Yes. Now tax due to government, 800 rupees given in the liability side, that is fully preferential, immediately to be settled or immediately is to be paid. So that is why 800 under preferential column, unsecured, nil. Trade creditor, I told you entire amount is unsecured. Preferential is nil, entire amount trade creditor or just creditor, 97,600, you can write under unsecured creditor column. Now just you need to make the total of these two. Preferential creditor total, that is 4,200 plus 800, that is 5,000 rupees. Unsecured creditor total, 1,100, 11,180, 2,100, 97,600. Add all these, you'll get 1,11,980. So now we know what portion is preferential, what portion is unsecured with the help of this working note. So after this working note, we can directly calculate this problem. And this liquidator's remuneration you can show below the format. Yes. So now let us see liquidator's final statement of account. So now receipt side, cash and bank information. Cash and bank information, first thing you need to enter in the receipt side. So whether cash and bank information is given, asset side they have mentioned you cash. See this cash, 500. So same cash you need to write here, 500. Yes, we have written. Then asset realized. Asset realized, we know some of the realized values are given in the adjustment. So add all those realized value, including the building which was taken for settling the partly secured creditor, that also we need to consider. Why? Because building is also realized. If you see, building value is 25,000, now it is realized at 18,000. That means there is some of the depreciation amount is there, depreciation amount in building. So now you can say building is valued at a lesser amount, 18,000. 18,000 plus machinery 25,000 plus debtor 43,500 plus stock 31,000. Add all these things, all the four information, you will get what? Asset realized. See this asset realized total, building, machinery, stock, debtor, that is 1,17,500. Yes. So after this, surplus from secured creditor, in this question nil. Why? Because secured creditors are there, that is partly secured creditor, but they don't have any securities with them, even though they have, it is not realized by them, it is realized by the liquidator. That is why here surplus from secured creditor is nil. So secured creditor surplus nil, So you can consider payment information immediately when it is nil here, receipt side, payment side, secured creditor, you have to enter the amount. Why? Because your payment is done by the liquidator to the secured creditor. That is why you need to write the amount in the payment side. Contributory is in this question nil. Why? Because there is no information regarding payments to the shareholder. Shareholder payment, they have not mentioned any information, not there. So receipt side total, that is 1,18,000. Yes, 1,18,000 we got. Now payment side, if you see payment side, secured creditor. Secured creditor is settled with the help of building. Building value is 18,000. That value you have to write in the payment side. 18,000 written. Legal charges. Legal charges nil. That is not there, not that is not given in the question. That is why it is nil. Now next thing we have to see, liquidator's remuneration. Liquidator's remuneration, 3% on asset realized. See, 3% on asset realized. So now asset realized, we know receipt side, it is there, asset realized. See this, 1,17,500. So this 1,17,500 into directly 3%, you will get 3,525. Or else you can show the working note also. See this calculation of liquidator's remuneration on 3% on asset realized, add all 4 asset realized, you will get 1,17,500 into 3%, that is 3,525. Same amount you have to write under liquidator's remuneration. Yes, here we have written. Now next thing, 2% on the amount realized to unsecured creditor. So this we will leave as it is for now. This we have to calculate later. So we'll see this later, unsecured creditor. Liquidation expenses is there. Liquidation expenses, if you see, that is given in the question, 1,100. So 1,100 you can write directly in the format. Liquidation expenses. Debenture holder, no information, nil. Preferential creditor. Now preferential creditor, we have done working note. If you see, we have divided creditors into preferential and unsecured with the help of working note. We have done that. So working note total you have to write here. Preferential creditor 5,000. How? See the working note here. Preferential creditor total, that is salary 4,200 plus tax due 800, total 5,000. This 5,000 we have written here, preferential creditor. Unsecured creditor is a balancing figure in this question, since there is no payment to preference shareholder as well as equity shareholder. So preference shareholder is nil, equity shareholder is also nil. So now we want amount available which is to be paid to the unsecured creditor. How to get the amount now? So you can show the working note here. See this. Here liquidator gets 2% on the amount paid to unsecured creditor. So receipt side total we want. Receipt side total is 1,18,000. 1,18,000 minus all the information in the payment side. First you need to deduct 18,000. Then you need to deduct liquidator's remuneration 3,525. Then this we have yet to be calculated. This is not calculated as of now. So leave this one. Next, liquidation expenses, we need to deduct 1,100. Preferential creditor, we need to deduct 5,000. If you deduct all these information, you will get that deductible amount, that is 27,625. This 27,625 deduct from receipt side balance, 1,18,000. 1,18,000 minus 27,625, you will get answer as 90,375. 90,375 is the amount available in the hands of liquidator to be paid to the unsecured creditor. Now before paying it, liquidator will get his commission, or liquidator will take his commission. So that you can calculate later also, but it is beneficial that you can calculate early. So 90,375, again you have to see unsecured creditor information given here. Unsecured creditor total, if you see, that is 1,11,980, and amount available now is only 90,000. So there is no sufficient balance available. You can say 1,11,000 is more than 90,000. So what happens? There is no sufficient balance. Formula 2/102. 2/102 on the amount available, 90,375 into 2/102. Answer 1772. This 1772 is their right. That is nothing but liquidator's remuneration. So this liquidator's remuneration, just below on the base of asset realized, that we have written 3%. On the base of unsecured creditors, see this 2%, that we have calculated 1772. Now we want final balance paid to the unsecured creditor. That is nothing but this 90,375 minus remuneration. 90,375 is amount available, from that remuneration is deducted remaining amount. So if you deduct these two information, you will get remaining amount, that is 88,603. That 88,603 is a unsecured creditor balancing figure. Or else what you can do, on this balance also you can calculate. Answer is same. If you calculating on the this balance, that is balancing figure 88,603, directly 2%. No need of doing 2 by 102, so that is not recommended. So before giving the amount to unsecured creditor, liquidator gets his remuneration. Yes, so any doubt in this problem, yes, tell me, have you understood this problem? Yes, tell me, any questions regarding this problem? Rajat is saying no. Pramod, I hope everyone understands this problem. Ashish, yes. What about others? Pratish, Shifali, Pooja, Suresh, Akamsha, Ankita, Disha, tell me, Vivek, Nishant, Omkar. I hope everyone understands this problem. Yes. So now, next problem we'll see. Next problem. Yes. Next problem. See this one. Problem number 7. Again, this is one more 12 mark problem. See this. The following particulars relates to a limited company which has gone into voluntary liquidation. You are required to prepare liquidator's final statement of account allowing for his remuneration at 2% on the amount realized on the asset and 2% on the amount distributed to unsecured creditor other than preferential creditor. So nothing new in this problem. If you see here, that is same thing. Whatever we have done in the previous problem regarding liquidator's remuneration, I am talking about. Liquidator's remuneration is same procedure. Asset realized you have to calculate. On the base of unsecured creditor, you have to calculate. That is same. So now next, if you see some of the balance they have mentioned. Unsecured creditor is 2,24,000. They have given. Then preferential creditor, that is 70,000. That is also mentioned. Debenture 75,000 given. Then asset realized, if you see, they have given you 4 items, that is realized. See this, one is cash in hand. Cash in hand 20,000 mentioned. Land and building 1,30,000. Plant and machinery 1,10,500. Fixtures and fitting 7,500. These 4 assets given, and it is given at a realized value directly. Then liquidation expenses amounted to 2000 rupee. So what is different in this problem? This adjustment. See this, a call of rupees 2 per share on the partly paid 10,000 equity share. So there is a call made, that is 2 per share. There is some partly paid shares are there, that is 10,000 equity share given, was made and duly paid, except in the case of one shareholder owning 500 shares. That means everyone paid the call money except for one shareholder. That shareholder is having 500 shares. That shareholder has not given the money. So all the shareholders, those who have given the money to the company after making the call, or all the shareholder, those who have given the money to the liquidator to conduct the process of distributing the surplus to the right claimant. So now here what we have to do? only the payment made we have to consider under contributory. Why we have to write the payment made, that is under contributory? Because contributory information regarding to shareholders information or regarding members information. So directly you can say in this question, that is 10,000 minus 500 share, 10,000 minus 500 shares, 9,500 shares are paid, 500 shares are not paid. That is why 9,500 into call amount 2 rupees, 9,500 into 2 rupees, that is nothing but 19,000. 19,000 total amount you have to show under contributory. So now let us see this format. Yes, now solution part you have to see. Now solution, liquidator's final statement of account. See this, liquidator's final statement of account. First one, cash or bank balance. Cash or bank balance, whether it is given here. Yes, see this, under asset realized they have mentioned you cash in hand 20,000. Same 20,000 you have to write under receipt side. So this cash and bank balance was there at the time of liquidation. This cash and bank balance liquidator can use to settle the amount, settle the payment of various stakeholders or various liability holders. Yes, so now after that there is asset realized information. Asset realized, only three information. See this, land and building 1,30,000, plant and machinery 1,10,500, fixture and fitting 7,500. Add all these three things together, add all these three things, you'll get the total asset realized. See this, 1,30,000 plus 1,10,500 plus 7,500, 2,48,000. Yes, after this we have to write surplus from secured creditor. Whether surplus from secured creditor information is given in this question? No, unsecured creditor is there, preferential creditor is there, but secured creditor not there, that is why nil. Then contributory, I have told you there is a call made by the company and 9,500 shares are paid by the shareholder at a call amount of rupees 2. That is why now this amount is available to be distributed among the right claimant. So it is cash comes in, cash in hand or cash comes in. So that is why you have to write under contributory on 9,500 equity shares at 2 per share. So 9,500 into 2, that is 19,000 rupees. 19,000 rupees, see this. So now you have to make the total. We know receipt side only 4 information, cash 20 and asset realized 2,48,000. Contributory 19,000. Total is 2,87,000. See this, 2,87,000 is our total. Now payment side we have to enter all the information one by one as per the mode of payment. Same format we have to follow. So first one, secured creditor. Secured creditor not there, nil. Very simple. Legal charges also not given, nil. So we can write that. We have to write the format. Even though it is nil, you have to write secured creditor, very important. Legal charges you have to write even though amount is nil. Then third one, liquidator's remuneration. Liquidator's remuneration, asset realized 2% on asset realized. See this, 2% on 2,68,000. See this, 2,68,000. Why here we have taken 2,68,000? Because you have to see the adjustment. This is very very important. Now see this, if you see, you are required to prepare liquidator's final statement of account allowing for remuneration at 2% on the amount realized on asset. They have not mentioned excluding cash. In the previous problem they have mentioned excluding cash, asset realized. In this problem just they have mentioned asset realized. So cash is also asset. We know cash is also asset, current asset, cash in hand, cash at bank, current asset. So in this problem we are going to consider cash also, cash also for liquidator's remuneration calculation. So if you see here, 2,48,000 is asset realized plus cash or bank balance 20,000. 2,48,000 plus 20,000, 2,68,000. 2,68,000 into 2%, you will get 5,360. See this, 5,360 is a liquidator's remuneration. We got, we can show the working note. See this, working note you can show calculation of liquidator's remuneration. 2% on the asset realized, cash in hand, land, plant, fixture. Add all these things, take 2%. That's it, 5,360. We got that amount. Next, 2% on 1,32,000. What is this 2%? 2% is regarding amount distributed to unsecured creditor, yet to be calculated. So we'll leave this as it is now. So we'll move on to the next step. That is liquidation expense. Liquidation expense given in the question. Liquidation expense is 2000 mentioned. So you can take 2000 here directly. Debenture holder. Debenture holder, debenture information, whether it is given, debenture, yes, see this, debenture 75,000, whether they have mentioned any outstanding interest, not there, outstanding interest, not there. If there is any outstanding interest, you have to add the outstanding interest to the debenture value. How to add? You have to see the month, how many months it is outstanding, or how many years it is outstanding. If it is for 6 months, 6 by 12 you have to do. If it is 1 year, directly 12 by 12, or 12 by 12 you can do. Like that you have to calculate debenture holder. In this question, outstanding interest not there, 75,000 directly. Preferential creditor. Preferential creditor, if you see here, preferential creditor, they have given 70,000. Directly you can write 70,000. Under preferential creditor, amount column 70,000. Unsecured creditor, in this question, balancing figure. Since there is no payment to preference shareholder, equity shareholder. Here shareholders are making the payment to the company, and company is not going to pay to the shareholder because it is not given in the question. Actually, they'll make the payment eventually, but in the question they have not mentioned. Only shareholder will pay the call amount. That's it. That is why here preference shareholder nil, equity shareholder nil. So now we want unsecured creditor balance. How to get? First receipts I total. All the receipts I total you do 20,000, 2,48,000, 19,000. Total is 2,87,000. 2,87,000 minus payment side information. Minus payment side, that is, one is liquidator remuneration on the basis of asset realized 5,360. Then this we have not calculated as of now. Leave it as it is. Liquidation expenses deducted 2,000 minus debenture holder minus 75,000. Preferential creditor minus 70,000. So if you deduct all these things, again you can show here. See this, 2,87,000 receipts I total, deduction is 1,52,360. That I have told you how to deduct all the payment side information, excluding this amount, that is liquidator remuneration yet to be calculated. So you will get 1,52,360. That you can deduct from receipt side, you will get 1,34,640. This 1,34,640 is the amount available with the liquidator to be paid to the unsecured creditor. So this 1,34,000 something is there, right? So from that you have to take 2% liquidator's remuneration on the base of amount paid to the unsecured creditor. Now we have to see whether there is a sufficient amount or not. So now let us see the unsecured creditor information once again. Unsecured creditor value, see this, 2,24,000, very important. This we have to consider. 2,24,000 is the original amount or the due amount which company is going to pay to the unsecured creditor. But now after making all the payment, company is left, or the liquidator is left with only 1,34,640. That means here unsecured creditor payment, there is no sufficient balance. So unsecured creditor will get proportionate payment. Proportionate payment means like how we used to do for every 1 rupee, what is the amount unsecured creditor will get, same thing. So here on this amount, 1,34,640 into 2% divided by 102, since the amount is not sufficient, 2 by 102, you will get 2,640. This 2,640 liquidator's remuneration on the base of unsecured creditor transferred to the main format. See this main format, we have transferred it 2,640. Or else what you can do, after paying to the unsecured creditor directly 2% also you can calculate. That is also can be done, but not recommended. So if you see, now we want final balance to the unsecured creditor, that is 1,34,640 minus 1,34,640 is amount available minus 2,640 amount paid to the liquidator, remaining balance 1,32,000. 1,32,000 is given to the unsecured creditor. Now make the total. Obviously total is same, both the side, receipt as well as payment side, 2,87,000 both the side total. Yes, tell me, have you